wake up and pay attention.
If you wanna
be somebody new, wake up from somewhere. Wake up and pay attention.
Yeah.
The time is wake up now or never
to make your
dreams come true. You gotta wake up and pay attention.
Pay attention.
If you wanna wake up, be somebody. Wake up, go somewhere.
That was Pay Attention by Valeria Andrews and Ryan Toby off of the Sister Act 2 soundtrack. Sister Act 2 Back in the Habit is the name of the movie. Ryan Toby actually was part of an American hip-hop trio consisting of Ryan Toby, Robbie Pardlow, and Claudette Ortiz called City High. But there isn't anything, at least on Wikipedia, on Valeria Andrews. She's credited as just a classroom kid, whereas Ryan Toby gets a whole name, Wesley Glenn Amal James. Pretty good song. I really enjoyed this movie. I'm reading the reception, and it looks like it got critically panned. But I guess I get it. It is kind of like one of those stupid, you know, kid feel-good movies, you know, where it's just like they take these kids and they say they're hopeless, but then the kids are great in the end. It's like the School of Rock formula. I like it. We're listening to that today because we have a Lauryn Hill song from that very same soundtrack up in competition today. The movie was released in 1993, so I think this is the earliest Lauryn Hill song we'll have in the tournament. Hi, my name is Bean, and you're watching Battle of the Band. We're on day 9 of the Lauryn Hill tournament, and that is match 9 and round 1. Round 1 is only 11 matches long, so we're almost done with round 1. Round 2 will have 16 matches. If you're new here and you're wondering what the Lauryn Hill tournament is, let me explain. We took every single song that Lauryn Hill has released so far, and we threw them into a single elimination-style tournament. Now those songs are doing battle and head-to-head competition until one remains in the end, and that's the very best song that Lauryn Hill has released so far. First up today, we're going to be listening to I Remember, which was released in 2002 on her Unplugged set, MTV Unplugged number 2.0. And this song is another song, like most of them off of this album, it seems, that are directly addressing her Christian faith. She references Hebrews 4:13 by saying, "You saw right through me, and I could not hide. I was exposed just like a child." I don't know Hebrews 4:13, so let's look it up here. "Nothing in all creation is hidden from God's sight. Everything is covered and laid bare before the eyes of Him to whom we must give account." So basically, God sees everything you do. So even the negative things you do, you know, God sees that, and all you can do is try to be a better person instead of, you know, dwell on it. Instead of just wallow in, you know, being a horrible person. I don't need God personally to be a good person, but some people it helps. And, you know, I like a message that says be a good person. And maybe it helps to have somebody watching you the whole time, and that makes you a good person. But I just assume, you know, I want to be the kind of person I want to hang out with. It'll be going up against His Eye Is on the Sparrow, which is a classic gospel song performed by Lauryn Hill and Tanya Blount. I think it's Blount. It might be Blunt. It's spelled Blount anyway. But this is, of course, off of the Sister Act Back in the Habit soundtrack released in 1993. It's been a long time since I've heard this. I forgot that Lauryn Hill was even in that movie. I probably didn't even know who Lauryn Hill was when that movie came out, honestly. I mean, I did watch it when I was really young. It's like 10 when it came out. Let's go ahead and get into it. Here's I Remember.
I remember when you looked into my eyes, you saw right through me. And I yours to command. I'm yours to command. I feel so humble with you in my life. With you in my life, I remember when I looked into your eyes. I saw a reflection of myself,
got a pretty great voice, and that's all she really needs. The instrumentation again on that one was incredibly sparse, but really good. Like, her vocals are fucking solid. She even sounds good when her voice breaks. Sounds good. She's great. I like the song. Really cool. I definitely don't remember His Eyes on the Sparrow, so we're just gonna have to get into it. Here's His Eyes on the Sparrow.
His eye is on the sparrow, and I know He watches me. I sing because I know He watches me.
He watches me.
His eye is on the sparrow, and I know He watches.
I know.
Pretty great vocal performances by both singers on that one. Pretty hokey instrumentation, definitely the type of stuff you would hear in a movie like that. Or just some sort of like stage production. I don't know. It just sounds like, you know, really old. Not that that's a bad thing, but that's just what it sounds like. It makes it sound kind of hokey, like the way the synthesizer goes with the just everything about it. I don't know. It's dated as fuck. That's what it is. It's dated. It sounds like it's from the early 90s, and it's from a feel-good musical, which is what it is. I'm going to go with I Remember. I think it was a better song. The vocals, the lyrics were original for Lauryn Hill. It wasn't an old gospel song. She actually wrote this one. So technically the other's a cover. It's a duet where she has, you know, maybe half the duties there. So I think I Remember will be a good one to select for today. Like this video if you like the video and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Share with anyone you know who might be into this kind of content and let me know down in the comments which of these two songs you would have chosen if it were you in the hot seat today. That's all the Lauryn Hill action we've got going for the day, but please join me in just a little bit when we get down with our first semifinals video of the Magnetic Fields today. Until then, I hope you all have a great night, fantastic afternoon, and a wonderful morning. Thanks for watching. Bye.